Have you ever thought about our ape relatives and wondered if evolution is an ongoing and ever relentless process, then why haven't they already changed into some form of proto-human and started building fires and carving spears, cultivating all manner of technologies that can hurtle them toward a similar kind of civilization? And oh no, because before you know it, the last remnants of human civilization are being rounded up by hordes of horse-riding apes waving machine guns in the air. Alright, maybe things have gotten quickly out of hand, and I'll gladly tell you that's not how evolution works, but still, it's an interesting thought, isn't it? Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if apes evolved past humans? Roll the clip. For the curious amongst you, that scene was of course from 2014's Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, where this time Caesar wrestled to maintain dominance over his vast community of intelligent apes as pockets of humanity struggled to survive the outbreak of the devastating simian flu. And slowly the age of ape kind started to emerge from the wilderness, and I'm not saying that would necessarily happen in this hypothetical situation, but I'm also not saying that. Also, how amazing is Andy Serkis' performance in that film? And if our hypothetical apes had a Caesar, we'd pretty much all be screwed. But before we dive into this question, we first have to address the elephant in the room and pick apart the actual evolutionary sequence of events that explains away exactly why apes haven't already evolved past humans. And whilst it may seem like an obvious one, hey, we might learn something new in the process. The fact of the matter remains, we are apes. You, me, your parents, your best friend from high school, the weatherman, every single human being on this planet is a direct descendant of a shared common species that lived about 14 million years ago, and together in our fun little branch of the genetic tree, we share that distant cousin with Neanderthals, Australopithecus, Homo florensis, orangutans, gorillas, bonobos, and chimpanzees. We are all apes, and together we make up the taxonomic family hominids, also known as the great apes. We, however, obviously change quite a lot on our evolutionary journey, and so humans, although we are still considered hominid, we are also in fact the only hominin species with an N currently alive on our fair planet called Earth, given the fact that all of the others died out to make way for modern humans. And if you think that's confusing, take it up with the anthropologists, please. Now, you might be thinking, okay, so if we're from the same little branch as the great apes, why aren't orangutans doing their thing and forming orangutan villages and cultivating their own banana harvest? And the fact of the matter is, they haven't ever needed to, and neither did their ancestors. Not now, and not even 10 million years ago, where their own lineage began. Chimpanzees and bonobos alike are supremely adapted to their environment, and they survived for the better. But the key difference is, our ancestors needed to change. You see, it's easy to think about evolution as a linear, progressive kind of thing, constantly twisting and writhing toward greater and greater levels of complexity, but the reality is, evolution doesn't care. Evolution doesn't have a destination, it just keeps going. It keeps living, and ever since that single-celled amoeba split off into another, those exact same conditions are what eventually sprouted us, me and you and everyone else. And also, those are the same conditions that sprouted out our ape cousins too. Those awesome hairy fellas that fascinate us endlessly with their uncanny levels of curiosity, where the reason it feels like we're staring into a mirror when we look at apes is because we kind of are. The key similarity between the two of us is monkey see, monkey do. Living in trees worked for apes, so they stayed, but it didn't quite work for us, so we left. Simple. You see, evolution doesn't have a destination, there's no end game to it. And even if there was, which there isn't, humanity is certainly not the pinnacle of the evolutionary process, no matter how much we'd like to think we are. Evolution favors simplicity. To quote Jeff Goldblum as Dr. Ian Malcolm, life finds a way. The reason that humans walk on two legs is because our hominin Australopithecus relatives evolved human-like hips that let them walk on 2 feet and carry things across vast distances. Evolution did that because it was a useful skill for collecting and foraging food, and those that had that trait survived to carry it on. And those shared successful traits are what eventually gave rise to Homo sapiens roughly 200,000 years ago, our species who were able to survive in pretty much any any environment, under any kind of circumstances, and still are to this day. For the time being, anyway. And yet still our ape cousins continue to live on in trees and the canopies of the deep jungle, because it was still as evolutionary successful, and it still is today. However, let's get back to that elephant in the room, because currently on Earth, there are fewer than 500,000 of our simian cousins alive, and 4 out of 6 of the great apes are considered critically endangered. And that's not because of evolution failing to do its job, that's because of us. More than 5 billion humans live in countries with primates, and that ever-encroaching expansion of population is obliterating the habitat of the great apes. Through relentless logging, mining, hunting, and the illegal pet trade, and most critically, climate change. In fact, the stark reality is that even hypothetically speaking, humanity would completely wipe out our great ape cousins before evolution had a chance to kickstart life finding any kind of way. The truth of the matter is that it's pretty damn bleak, and the only hypothetical parameters of apes ever evolving past humanity is if some all-powerful cosmological force snapped their fingers and we all disappeared in an instant. Even under the most extreme circumstances, apes would never evolve past humans, because the truth is, we are the apes that evolve past the, well, the apes. The rest of our great ape family. Anyway, as far as we know, there has never been a species on Earth that has the capacity to understand the evolutionary process as comprehensively as we humans do. But maybe that's the exact point. Maybe life finding its way is to enable us to ensure the survival of our most vulnerable species and prevent them from disappearing entirely. You see, that's because there are still many things that can be done to save the great apes. And yeah. That includes us humans, too. Well, there we have it, our long and short answer to the question, what if apes evolved past humans? They couldn't, because they're happy living in trees and eating bananas, but we should really do something about how we treat their environment. Also, we are apes. What did you guys think? Do you agree, disagree, have any interesting insights to add? Please let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below. Before we depart from today's video, if you'd like to continue on with your questioning binge, then make sure to click our playlist compiled conveniently for your viewing enjoyment. Unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Just stick around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video, or just life's biggest questions in general, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe button, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions, and until next time, you take it easy.